We just walked down the side of the cliff, and about 3/4 of a mile. It was awesome.
It's awesome. It's nice, but climbing up, it's hard.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
It was my dream to see Grand Canyon before I die. There it is.
GeoFORCE is a summer outreach program for high-achieving high school students in the Houston area and South Texas area. It's a four-year program. We take the students in the summer between 8th and 9th grades and then follow them through high school. We take students out, show them spectacular things in geology, and then teach them the science behind it. So that really gets them motivated to learn it.
There's a need for future geoscientists because those that are currently in the field will retire, and there's a projected deficit of qualified geoscientists, and so we're trying to fill that pipeline now.
The geosciences are critical for our civilization to continue to survive from the standpoint of energy, water, building materials. I could go on and on and on.
That's why we need geologists. You know, those are the people that find oil and gas. Those are the people that find minerals and metals and things like that that we need. They take care of water, which is going to be a huge, huge thing in the near future of needing more water resources, and that's geology too.
We're trying to diversify our student population because of the changing population of the state of Texas. Help solve this country's energy problems for the future. Everybody knows we need to do that, so here's hoping.
GeoFORCE is the ultimate geoscience experience for outstanding students across the state of Texas.
Being able to travel to different places that I probably wouldn't ever have the chance to.
Because how many people in the world can say that they hiked the Grand Canyon at 14 or 15 years old?
Right.
I mean, here we are at the south rim of the Grand Canyon. We really don't have to do a lot of getting them up every hour of every day saying, all right, we're going to go look at this. We need to get excited about it, because the things that we take them to and the things that they see really do speak for themselves. We get up very early, 6 a.m. on average every morning, eat breakfast, and then we pile on the bus and we head off.
Last night when Julie announced that the students could sleep in until 6:45, a whoop went up.
Like at our houses, we wake up like at 12 or something.
Yeah.
And now 6:45 is late for us.
It's intense, but if they didn't like it, they wouldn't be coming back, and they sure are coming back year after year.
It's a once in a lifetime that they take you out, and then you experience a whole new environment that you've never been in.
I get to go out of Texas for the first time, fly on a plane, and I like exploring.
This is like my very first trip out of the state of Texas, and my first time riding the airplane, so like everybody was excited because I'm excited to be here.
Many of the kids haven't been on airplanes before, so the first adventure for them was actually getting on a plane.
You know, the wheels go up on the airplane and everyone screams.
Very interesting. First time flying.
Basically, I was panicking, you know, heart going at like 50 miles per hour.
Very scared. Terrified.
It was all right.
She was like, oh my God!
None of you were alive when Mount St. Helens was erupted, but leading up to the eruption, a lot of people knew that something was going to happen at Mount St. Helens. A couple of months leading up to it, there was a big dome or a bulge that formed on the north flank. And then on the morning of May 18th, there was that magnitude 5.3 earthquake. It caused that whole dome, that whole bulge, to collapse as a big landslide. So if you look over on that hill right there, see what the direction the trees are blown down or knocked down? That's how geologists could reconstruct what direction the blast went.
They're real cool.
They're good teachers.
Yeah, they make it real easy to understand real abstract stuff.
It's always a challenge to explain things in a way that people can understand them. If I can't explain it to them in a way that they can understand, then I probably don't understand it myself very well.
What do you think, Riley? Yeah?
That's correct.
Yeah!
Teachers are great.
The teachers are great.
Very.
Julia is awesome.
Very up tempo. They're great, man. I like that. They're not boring.
I like their methods. They have dances to show us, to help us comprehend the movements of the Earth's plates.
This is volcano. Yeah, transform, and yeah, like this.
Maybe in the test, you can't think about it, but then you go back to that dance and you know it.
All right, transition into the divergent dance.
Transitioning to the convergent. And now, subduction. That's great. And with volcano.
It's really cool just to get an opportunity to put your hands on stuff and get out in the field.
You can actually go out and see Mount St. Helens. You can see the damage that was caused when it erupted. So it's a lot more interesting, and it just gets the students more engaged.
Yeah, I like that. They teach good stuff, man. I'm actually learning. Here.
The students work hard, and we're teaching at a very high level, getting them to understand concepts that I didn't learn until some of them my sophomore year in college.
It's pretty cool to think about that. Like, wow, I'm learning some pretty intense stuff right now, but yeah. I get it.
They are A and B students in math and science. So what this program does is it brings them together, and then they see that there are other people like them, and that they're not some anomaly within their school and their family.
That's a beautiful picture.
When the kids get here, they're used to being at the top of their class, and they're used to everything coming very easily to them. You know, the teacher gives instruction and they get it right away. It's very intuitive.
We've often heard the kids say that they're not used to being surrounded by kids who are smart. As a result, they're not as challenged. Additionally, in their schools, it's not always cool to be smart. And being around kids who are truly their peers academically and intellectually is a new experience for them. And at first, they're intimidated by being around people who are equally talented and smart.
All of this just kind of ups their game, and they just rise to the occasion, and they ended up doing very well. And it kind of takes them out of this high school atmosphere and into more of a collegiate level.
A lot of them might not have ever had parents that went to college. And so I think that's a really big deal to try and get these kids to know that they can do it. If I hadn't had somebody when I was in high school that told me that I could be a geologist, I could do this, I wouldn't have known.
Science wasn't my best for a while.
No, I didn't like it at all, really. It was kind of difficult, really. I didn't want to apply myself. But until I got into an engineering program, I found out I could have a feature in this, geoscience engineering, or electrical engineering, some kind of engineering field. But geoscience helped me in that.
The majority of students do not know each other coming into this program. And I know that the friendships formed here are going to last many years to come for these kids.
It's totally worth it. You meet so many wonderful, fabulous people, and those friendships are probably going to last you a lifetime.
I hope the students can take away an appreciation for the Earth and a way to question things so that they see something and they think, well, how did that get there? There must be a reason.
Like sometimes you think, like, what would have been here before? What would geology help you, like, you can figure out what it was.
You can solve problems.
Yeah.
Mysteries that it
helps you tell you.
This, look around, this is what we get to do for a living. Going out and being in the field, it's just a really rewarding job, and I love it. Everything is kind of interrelated on our planet, and geology kind of brings it all together. So even if you don't want to be a geologist, you can be a chemist or a biologist.
All these things are great benefits to our society, and that's what the Jackson School's GeoForce program is really focused on.
By the end, everyone is it's a big family, and they don't want to go home. We can't wait to see them again the next summer.